It's 4:30 p.m. in St. Anne's, a suburb with the second highest crime rate in the city.
Evening, you've got myself and 2900.
PCs Dale Notley and Tiff Hutchinson are responding to a family dispute. It's a grade one call, which means someone's life could be in danger, so they need to get there within 15 minutes.
There's a gentleman inside the flat demanding some money. He's poured petrol, I think, somewhere inside the house. A couple of cops have just been heading over at the moment, so we're just backing them up, make sure everyone's okay. 102 Street 6.
The patio doors at the back are unlocked, and there's a strong smell of petrol coming from the house.
We need to get a couple of extinguishers out, it does smell like petrol.
You could smell it actually approaching the address from the street, so much so it kind of took your breath away.
Liquid on the floor.
There's a report of a smell of gas too.
I think we should just back off this gas.
So the cops retreat and await the fire service.
We're just going to clear the houses either side to be safe.
Yeah.
The surrounding area is evacuated.
Yeah, grab your coats and stuff. We've got a potential gas leak next door.
It is an emergency, so I need to evacuate you from your house.
I believe we've got a male inside the house who's put petrol everywhere at the moment, and we can smell gas. We've got ambulance on standby and fire brigade. So at the moment, we're just making sure everyone's safe at the moment either side.
Obviously, there's lives at risk here, so it's as quickly as we can just to get a nice circumference around the property.
When the firefighters arrive, Tiff gives them the lowdown.
It was the living room, right. And there's a strong smell of petrol, and officers have been around the back and there's a smell of gas.
Right.
So it's accessible from the rear.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm happy to go in if... Do you want to come?
Yeah,
with
I'll room? Come, yeah.
They think the man responsible has poured petrol over himself and could still be upstairs.
Petrol can in the room.
It's the police.
When we entered the address, I do recall seeing all the petrol on the floor. The main concern for me and also the officers was that is there a naked flame? Is the gentleman inside there with something that could ignite the fuel?
Where are you?
TV on the third bedroom.
If he sets light to himself, the whole house could go up in a ball of fire.
I'm going in. There is a danger there, but you tend to put that in the back of your mind. No one in here. Clear.
The house is empty. Now they need to make sure there isn't a gas leak.
Are we happy about the gas? Can we smell gas now? All I can smell is petrol.
The gas is confirmed to be safe.
All right, let's let people back in then.
And neighbours can return to their homes.
I can only thank you so much for your time.
It's all right.
Apologies for the, you know, the immediacy, but it's really important that we get you out as soon as possible.
The homeowner, the mother of the man they're after, has turned up. She's been receiving texts from her son, which explain his extreme behaviour.
He's got a drug dealer on his back, and it's stressing him out badly.
She reads out some of the texts her son has sent to her.
I'm going to smash half the pieces. Get me arrested, I couldn't give it up. Take me this 40 quid, you FFIHO. This house is going up. I still want to stab one of you. What's stopping me burning your house down right now? I'm soaking myself in petrol. If any police try pulling me, I'm going in a blaze.
It's as serious as it gets. Someone that's doused himself in petrol. I've got imminent concerns for their safety and others as well, so it's important that we locate them as soon as we can.
They've asked for help from a special service, which can pinpoint the location of a mobile phone.
One thing that's going to be really useful if we can get authority is something called Spock. That's basically where we're able to triangulate the phone. It's only for very serious cases, which this would fit that criteria. So hopefully we'll get authority for that and see if we can narrow down the search for a particular area.
And with a lad threatening to set himself on fire, anything could happen.
Take him.
Just take him down.
Straight down to the ground.
Straight down.
Don't give him a chance for anything.
PCs Tiff Hutchinson and Dale Notley are on the hunt for a man who's thought to be drenched in petrol. They've asked for help using a restricted and confidential police procedure, often used to help find missing people, known as Spock.
Spock stands for single point of contact.
It's the ability for us to triangulate a mobile phone, and it gives us a radius of where that subject could be.
The signal strength from three phone towers nearest the mobile is needed. While they wait for results, Tiff and Dale head to the home of some relatives of the wanted man.
There is going to be a worry about his mental state, but the main thing is to get to him and stop him from causing himself any harm. We have a criminal matter, but firstly, we've got to look at seeing if we can get him help.
The family tell the cops the lad may be armed with a knife. They give an address where he could have gone.
Tactical options is now, because if he's still covered in fuel, we can't use a taser, because that will light him up like a Christmas tree. So we'll have to use, if he kicks off, CS, to try to subdue him.
His family are at a breaking point. They don't know what else to do. They've tried everything.
The friend living at the next house has recently come out of prison and has an electronic tag to make sure he sticks to his curfew. So they know he should be in.
What's his tag for? What offence was it for?
Arson and criminal damage.
On the way, they get confirmation that they're on the right track.
We've had reports from the SPOC inquiries we've had from his mobile phone, which are indicating that he's within probably half a mile of the address that we're actually going to now.
Other officers have also arrived as backup.
His SPOC is pinging to this area, very, very close. It's arson with intent to endanger. He might be carrying a knife. Oh, OK. Hello, mate, you all right?
You all right?
Yeah, good. Can we come in for 2 minutes? Is that all right?
What's up?
We just need to have a chat with you.
What about?
Look, do you want us to come in and we'll have a chat? Yeah. Thank you.
There's no smell of petrol, and the occupants tell the police the man they're after isn't there.
Have you heard from him? OK.
But Tiff and Dale aren't convinced.
At the minute, we've got real concerns for him. Out of everything, his safety is the main thing.
So you've come here?
We've come here.
Yeah.
Well, I know you're friends with him.
Yeah.
Yeah. His phone's showing that it's in the area.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why we're here. Makes sense, doesn't
it? Is he in here, mate?
No.
They want to search the house, but the couple have young children upstairs.
With your consent, are we all right to just have a quick look round, just to make sure?
No, I don't really want you upstairs. You and my kids are in bed.
You kind of have to think outside the box, and it was actually Dale that was able to separate that guy from his partner.
Let's have a chat in here. Right, mate. With us, right, the phone's pinging this area, and it's shown to you. If we find out later that he has been here, all right, and you've lied, you'll be brought in, mate. You know what'll happen.
I'll be brought in.
Obstructing police.
Obstructing police?
Yeah. We need to talk to him. We need to get him some help.
It's fine. He's here. It's fine.
He's here?
Yeah, fine.
Mate, we need to talk to him. Where is he? Mate, if you don't tell, you'll come in with us, and you don't want to. You're on tag. Upstairs.
All of a sudden, the man they've been hunting for the past 4 hours, appears.
Am I getting arrested?
Just come down.
Come down.
Let me talk to you. Chap, first of all, have you got anything on you?
The man is arrested for trying to set light to his mother's house and placing lives in danger.
Suspicion of... Just one sec, let me finish speaking. On suspicion of arson with intent, it's an attempt.
There was a concern, but getting close, we couldn't smell any petrol on him whatsoever. So I think to let him have that cigarette and calm down. So, yeah. So he did calm down rather than go up.